the first time I met Aaron Connell was at Waimea Skate Park, and I like saw YouTube videos of Big Island skateboarders before I came out, and his name popped up, and I watched some of his videos, and I was like, hell yeah, dude, there's some cats that shred out here. And then meeting him, like, in real life, the dude shreds, and we kicked it, and not too long after I met him, I was, like, kind of hard up and living out of my car, and he told me, yo, man, you can stay at my crib. So I moved in, and I shredded with that dude, like, every day. He stayed on, like, a serious, like, regimen of, like, skating, filming, just getting tricks, always evolving. And I was hyped, you know what I mean? Like, seeing it in person, it's crazy because that cat's got a crazy bag of tricks. You know what I mean? I seen him do shit that I wasn't accustomed to seeing. Like, his technical skills are unparalleled. And it's been a good time knowing that fool, and I'm glad I'm out here still and we're still ripping, you know what I mean? Because that kid kills it. And he always pushes me to, like, get tricks or try something harder because I know, like, damn, like, he would do something better than that. So he's just been a big point for, like, the skating out here and pushing guys to, like, step their game up and get technical. And you can totally see it in the whole Big Island scene how, like, everybody's kind of pushing the limits of, like, you know, backflip, flip, late flip, flip in, flip out, man. And that kind of stemmed with, like, this homie Aaron Connell that I met, you know, so he's a rad dude for sure, big heart, and shows lots of love to all the homies, man.
Well, Aaron Connell, man, he's quite the inspiration. I grew up skiing with him. He's probably the childhood hero for most skateboarders growing up on the Big Island. He's very innovative and very inspirational to us all growing up skating, and he's very friendly and down to earth and a loving person, and he'll skate with anybody and he'll skate with everybody for hours. He's just a skate rat, man. Skateboarding just runs through his veins. He's always daydreaming about spots he wants to go to and tricks he wants to film, and he just loves it so much. I don't think he thinks about anything else. He just loves it so much. And I just hope that he continues doing what he loves, because it makes him happy and it makes all the people around him that are skating happy. And as long as he's doing that, he's living the dream. And I'm proud of him because he's a great guy. And he's gonna do great things with his future looking bright.
You know, there's much I can say about Aaron Connell, but this guy is definitely, you know, a role model for a lot of people on the Big Island of Hawaii and all over the world. And, you know, that's really what I love about skateboarding is, you know, I look at it as an art, and, you know, for people, it's something that people can just do every single day to really get their mind off of, you know, the world, and really just focus on expressing their freedom to, you know, to other people. And the fact that you can touch so many people, you know, all over the world with what you do, can really leave a significance in other people's lives. And, you know, that's really what I love is, you know, I've seen Aaron, you know, throughout my whole, maybe 2 to 3, maybe my whole life, because I've known Aaron, you know, in the skateboarding community. And, you know, not only has this guy progressed as a skateboarder, but definitely progressed as a human being and really giving back to his own town. And, you know, definitely working very hard, you know, and putting together the new skateboard that Hong Kong came about, and just for the people, you know, in the town. And, you know, especially in Hawaii, it's tough, and, you know, there's not much spots to skate, but the fact that Aaron kind of just went out there and, you know, made it happen and made it possible to show people that, you know, you can make a lot out of little things, you know, a lot out of a little thing. And, you know, I truly believe that's really what skateboarding is you can do it anywhere you want. And it doesn't matter if you're in a small town or if you're in a big city, you know, just the fact that you can go out and really have fun with your friends and progress and learn new things, and also live a life there to experience. And the fact that, you know, I've known Connor from day one, and, you know, obviously he's always been a phenomenal skater and definitely somebody I look up to. But more importantly, he's just somebody that, you know, definitely grew as a person, you know, and I know that personality kind of goes a long way in skateboarding because, you know, when you portray yourself in the skateboarding world, yeah, you know, tricks are great, things are great, but when you actually come off as a great person, that's what really seems all about it. You know, I truly believe that that personality goes a long way in the skateboarding world, and, you know, Connor is definitely somebody I trust and somebody I respect, and I know, you know, when he puts his mind to something, you know, no matter if it's a trick that a stair set or if it's a trick that he's trying to get, he's willing to take the fall, take the hit, get back up, and willing to go at it again and again. Doesn't matter if you did it that day, he's willing to go back, and that's what really life is getting up, you know, when you're down, and just going back and getting it. And, you know, Colin was one of those guys that are always striving to be better. It doesn't matter if it's his life or skateboarding, and, you know, that's what I really respect about him is, you know, it's just seeing him just going out there and being the best person possible to his, you know, family and to the skateboarding world. And, you know, just him as a person is just, you know, it's crazy because, you know, he's been there for me in my life as a friend. He's been there in my life as a skateboarder. And I know everyone watching this video right now, you know, is hyped on it just because I know if you knew Kano personally for your whole life, you know that he transitioned and he's such a phenomenal skateboarder. You know, skateboarding is an ever-changing thing. People are constantly growing, and Kano always looks at the newest beginner as somebody that definitely can model themselves after someone great. And he looks at himself and he humbles himself and grounds himself. And, you know, I truly look up to him as a role model. And there's so much respect that goes out to him and his family and to the skateboarding world and for what he's done. And, you know, if something great was to happen with him and the skateboarding world, it wouldn't surprise me. I would just look and be like, man, that guy was destined to do something great. You know, and I know that the puzzle pieces is finally coming together. And, you know, for him to really put together his project to touch other people that around the world is just, it's a significant thing. And I honestly am grateful and honored, you know, to know Kano in my life and to see what he's doing with the skateboarding community is changing the way I look at it and the way that everyone's looking at it. And I'm just hyped. This is exciting. So, hell yeah, Kano.